Keroche Breweries is investing 5 billion shillings to increase its capacity tenfold and help it grow its share of the alcohol market sixfold to 20% in about a year. Tabitha Karanja has told Reuters that the money is being spent on the construction of a new 1 million hectolitres a year brewhouse and bottling line to be launched this month that will help the company raise its market share from 3%. Owned by the Karanja family, Keroche started by making spirits and wines in 1997 before diversifying into beer in 2008.
Immediately after the beer got into the market, we knew that the capacity that we had already launched was not enough. So we had to go back again to our drawing board so that we could think of how we can increase the capacity.
Its Summit Lager and Summit Malt beers compete with products by Diageo's East African Breweries, which enjoys a commanding lead with popular brands that include Tusker.
Being the first truly Kenyan to invest in brewing in the country, and of course it was a challenge because even people, you know, we as Kenyans or Africans, we don't believe in ourselves. So from there, it had to take time. It took time before people could realize, hey, Kumbe, even as we can even do better than what the multinationals can do.
The expansion is 80% funded through a loan from Barclays, while the rest was generated internally. Karanja said the increased production will also allow Keroche to start distributing its other products, which include spirits and table wines, in Uganda and Tanzania.
There's a gap because people need choice, and this choice, what people are looking for, is of higher premium, you know, higher premium beer that is naturally brewed, 100% malted beer, brewed beers and all that. That's what people are looking for. They want a quality beer.
Keroche's chief executive has said the company will consider putting up a malting plant in the future if no other investor will step forward to build one at a minimum cost of 1 billion shillings, adding that Kenyan brewers rely on imported malt.